Yeah.
It's very nice to meet
you. How are you?
Thank you for making the trip. We appreciate it.
Okay. The autopsy report includes chemical analysis, toxicology, and I reviewed some witness statements and police statements. And I gained the impression that the autopsy was done properly and was done well. So is there anything that would, based on the autopsy, account for this crash? Alcohol and marijuana, if you will.
We obviously don't know much about this, but she would not do this. There's something wrong with this picture. And I don't want her being a poster child for drunk moms, because she would never do that. You tell me my sister does it, my sister who passed away, I tell you yes. She probably was drinking, 100%. But this just wasn't Diane. This wasn't his wife. She'd be the very one that would, like, yell at us or kick our butt.
What are we going to do?
I just feel, which, you know, it's just me being my strong opinion, is as soon as they saw alcohol, it was all stopped. Okay, she was drunk, she was high, that's it. Categorize that, drunk mom driving five kids in the car.
What about the abscess tooth?
The which?
Abscess tooth.
An abscess tooth.
Could that cause a stroke?
It doesn't.
Could that cause a stroke?
Yeah.
In theory, yes. But based on the autopsy, there is none that I saw on microscopy. A stroke is something like this. And it doesn't cause alcohol
formation. But could that reading be a mistake due to other medical conditions that people don't know that she had?
It could, but the question of the alcohol will always prevail.
So say we exhume the body and is a really bad abscess tooth. We have x-rays from years ago.
But the question will still prevail. How did it have caused alcohol in the vitreous?
Maybe she had a stroke and by mistake she thought that was water and drank it.
We don't, if someone tells us, we want to know what physically happened to that. If she did have alcohol in her, did she stop and be incoherent and do something medically happen to her? That we're even willing to bet to say that, but there's no way if she was in her right state of mind she would go and take that bottle. So now if you tell me she was having a stroke or she was hallucinating or she was this or she was that due to an abscess, we're going to have to live with that.
If she did have an abscess, she could have had such pain. She takes whatever is available to alleviate the pain.
No, I don't think so. I think
she wouldn't do the pain. She'd either have to be not thinking it's water.
Well, she's not thinking clearly because she had a tooth abscess.
Right. That's what I'm thinking.
Okay. So if she had a tooth abscess, what you could do is say to yourself, she had severe pain and she had to alleviate that pain now, not in an hour, now.
So she drank 1.9
in 45 ounces. Minutes.
Well, you know,
who drank once a month, maybe?
Look, it really doesn't make sense, my trying to convince you. You have to have your satisfaction. Your satisfaction is only going to be achieved if you send it to another laboratory to redo it.
So that would be the next step.
That's the only way I know what to tell you.
And then also and then exhuming. That's the way to go, right?
Yep.
It's very frustrating. People have promised us the world that they were going to find out, get to the bottom of it, retest everything, do this and do that, and nobody has done anything. It's a year and 3 months.
You mean when you say people, you mean?
Our investigator was supposed to get the samples and send them to another lab to check DNA.
And you didn't do it?
We don't know.
No.
That's what we've been asking for. Right?
Yep.
Well, we do appreciate you looking at everything and doing this.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, you're welcome. Mm. I I sincerely hope that you'll find peace with this.